Welcome back to our British-Romanian Encounters on International Museum Day. I'm absolutely delighted to welcome our guests today, Mrs. Paula Popoiu, the director of the Dimitri Augusti National Village Museum in Bucharest. Good afternoon, Mrs. Popoiu. Thank you for joining us on a very unusual International Museum Day.
Good afternoon. Hello from Romania, from Bucharest, from Village Museum. And thank you also for the invitation to meet again London in May, May 18. This is indeed an unusually International Museum Day. By the other hand, yesterday the Village Museum celebrated its 84th anniversary.
Please tell us more about the museum. The National Village Museum is well known by Romanians who most likely would have visited at least once in their life. But for our international friends who perhaps have not traveled to Bucharest yet, it might be useful if you could offer them a flavor of what it is.
Okay, it's a very, very short history. Village Museum was founded in 1936. And the idea of this village museum belonged to the great sociologist and philosopher Dimitri Augusti. It's also the leader of the sociologic school of Bucharest. Dimitri Augusti organized between 1925 and 1935 a number of research in 600 villages of Romania, of all Romania. And another founder, we consider another founder, the Royal Cultural Foundation, Prince Charles, who support morally and materially the project. During the work, the King Carol II of Romania visited the site of the museum four times. It's very interesting. The museum is located in the middle of Bucharest, but near airport. And finally, we are a national museum and our objective are to collect, document, research and preserve material and immaterial heritage and history of traditional Romania. And we have a documentation center, we have a big laboratory for conservation and restoration patrimony. And we have also a very important archive with 200,000 documents, a very important archive of a sociological school. And the thematic of our open air exhibition is traditional pre-industrial and installation, traditional architecture, farms, houses, church, we have five churches organized by historical region, Transylvania, Valachia and Moldavia. And we have 15 hectares, it's a big museum. We have 380 monuments. And last year we have 900,000 visitors. It's the most visited museum in Romania. And we have a lot of service for our public, for visitors, temporary exhibition with our collection or private collection, education program, animation for the children, it's living museum, school education program, a lot of folk music, dancing, restaurant, open air, theater, a lot of festival for Christmas, for
Easter,
the festival for all the tradition in the Romanian village. And it's very important, the National Village Museum is a place to be for the family with children. We have a lot of mothers here with children. And because we are an old museum, we have a lot of program for young generation.
Are there any particular houses that in the museum that stand out for you personally?
Yes, of course. Of course, we have first of all the oldest houses date from 17th century, but the most visited houses in the museum it's Shantz House. It's a house from northern Transylvania who was transferred in the museum in 1936. The village Shantz, it's important because it's used to be inhabited by border guards who during the history enjoy some privileges that have been reflected in the proportion and the volume of the building. And another house, this is a museum, it's the beginning of the museum, it's archive of our museum. But another house in the museum, it's Selcua household of Alba Canti. Also it's the image for the museum. A lot of children and Selcua. This is the map of the beginning of the museum. And Selcua household, it's also a very important house. It's a house of area of Apusen Mountains. And the most visited indeed is Juri Lovca household, Tulcea County near Black Sea. This house, Juri Lovca, it's a house of village situated on the banks of Razelm Lakes, and it's representative for the Russian population who has settled here in 17th century. This house is the most visited house in the museum, but we have a lot of houses and five churches, and we must visit the village museum for this. This is Juri Lovca houses. It's characteristic for Russian population. And this is a museum in the winter. We have a big winter here.
Is the museum still extending its collections? And if yes, what kind of artifacts are of interest for you?
Of course, the museum is interested in the development of our collection. We have over 60,000 objects in collection. Beside those that I exhibit in the 300 houses of the museum, we are a museum of traditional architecture, so we are interested in the development of collections that look at the traditional life in the village, but we are especially interested in the traditional costume icon on the glass, because we collect probably the last object from the village. Starting with the years 2008, we developed a new part of the museum, open air exhibition, 3 hectares and 30 monuments transferred from the village, and I am sure saved from destruction.
Who is the typical visitor of the museum?
It's a very interesting question. Last year we had 900,000 visitors. More than half were foreign tourists, but we have loyal visitors from Bucharest who return to the museum for important events or participate in workshop for children and family. We have many mothers who come to creative camps with their children during the holidays. Generally, our visitors are very diversified in terms of professional training or cultural level. And we are also visited by important personalities, including Prince Charles of Great Britain. The museum is a top destination in Romania, indeed.
Do you know if your foreign visitors are from Europe? Do you have any figures from the UK or outside Europe?
Yes, we have all Europe here, Italian, French, Great Britain, and have also Asiatic country, Arabian country. In museum, we have indeed all the people of international people.
From everywhere. And what are the challenges of running the Dimitri Agusti National Village Museum?
This is indeed interesting for a leader of the museum. There are many challenges for any museum leader, but I think here in the Village Museum, I must say that I lead 160 people, employments, with different backgrounds and personalities. I think the biggest challenge is need to get out of the routine and provide new and attractive activities for the public, for a lot of people, to ensure its fidelity. Another big challenge is the money. I manage here a village only because we have no inhabitant, but the maintenance needs are about the same. And this is indeed a challenge for me and for my colleagues also.
The pandemic must have been a really difficult time for everyone connected with the National Village Museum. We even saw some pictures that you sent me taken during the pandemic. What has happened since the pandemic started, and what are the plans for the immediate future? When are you planning to reopen the museum?
Yes, first of all, it is very difficult to accept in this period the loneliness of the museum. We're used to having more visitor streets full of people, especially for children, but we have adapted to the times. Now we prepare the opening of the museum Wednesday, the 21st of May.
So in 1 week.
Yes. Mm-hmm. But in the pandemic, we worked a lot of for evidence and heritage conservation, and we work a lot of activity online dedicated to the public, especially for children who stay in house. For example, we read stories and presented traditional crafts for the little one. And I think we have a lot of success because we have 1 million visitors online.
And do you know if you will have special requirements for the public when you will open next week?
For the moment, it's difficult to say.
What exciting new projects are you preparing for your visitors?
We have a lot of projects, but for the moment, we have not yet overcome the moment of the pandemic. And our activity with the public still remains in the online space. But we have to do restoration for the houses in the museum, and I think we will turn them into real and interesting show with the public. I think have a lot of workshop for children, but two or three children for an workshop. And we plan many temporary exhibition in the hall of exhibition of our museum. We have four hall of exhibition, and I don't know if it's allowed. It will be allowed. We will resume our normal program regarding the organization of traditional fairs, a show, creative camp for children. And this year we were planning a medieval camp with life belonging to the Middle Age. But I don't know in this moment if we can have this kind of plan.
You were in London 5 years ago for the Revisiting Romania Dress and Identity exhibition at the Horniman Museum, the prestigious British museum with extensive collections of anthropology, natural history, and musical instruments. In fact, the National Village Museum kindly supported a series of special events. What memories do you have about the Romanian objects in the Horniman collection?
Yes, it's very, very nice, very interesting exhibition. I was impressed by the object in the museum collection. And the Saxon costume is very, very interesting, very nice. It was a good collaboration with the Horniman Museum, which continued in Romania. And we had with us two exceptional craftsmen, creator of object, but also very important, who know how to bring with them the air and the atmosphere of the traditional village. And we are impressed by the collection of the Horniman Museum and also by the friendly meeting and exchange of ideas with a specialist of Horniman Museum. And I hope to have a collaboration in the future.
What do they have there? There were a lot of costumes, blouses, instruments, household objects.
Yes, I see the exhibition is with the collection of Horniman Museum and the collection of Village Museum. It's a dialogue between, but we have this exceptional craftsman with us, and we have demonstration how we paint the icon and make the folk mask, and Romanian still, I think it's Romania still has living traditional crafts, and I think for us it's interesting, and we have the luck that other countries have lost to see the village life and the life of the past. And to see the woman who sew traditional costume. We also have traditional house craftsmen in the village. It's living history in Romania village.
You've partially answered to my next question, which was about this exhibition being the one of the largest Romanian folk costumes ever showcased in the UK, and also brought these objects into dialogue with contemporary craft makers, as you've mentioned, Daniel Leș, Mihail Abădescu, and Paul Buță, who had live demonstrations how pots, icons, and folk masks come to life from the humblest materials. Do you think Romania is exceptional in the way its craftsmen continue to relate to the past and traditions?
Yes, I think we have this formidable, extraordinary luck to have in the Romanian village craftsmen, old craftsmen, but we have also a new generation who are interested by the tradition. It's interested in a traditional costume, icon, mask. I think all generation of craftsmen has an occasion to conserve and to have a dialogue with new generation and to conserve the local tradition in a school with this young man is not a lot, but we have a hope.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Popoiu, for taking the time to speak with us on what is surely a very busy day for you with preparing to reopen the museum and with your future projects. Thank you, stay healthy, and we look forward to visiting the Village Museum when we will be in Bucharest.
Thank you for this dialogue, and excuse me for my English, because I speak French, is my generation. And I hope to have a lot of visitors in the future of Great Britain also, and we have also another visit from Prince Charles.
Thank you very much, and bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.